إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من بين خلقه وخليله، أرسله الله بالهدى والدين الحق فأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة، فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا، أما بعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما، أما بعد، معاشر المؤمنين، أوصيكم وأوصي نفسي بتقوى الله. فقد ورد عن أبي الدرداء وعن أبي ذر رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما يرويه عن ربه جل في علا: يا عبادي، إني حرمت الظلم على نفسي وجعلته بينكم محرما فلا تظالموا. يا عبادي، كلكم ضال إلا من هديت فاستهدوني أهدكم. يا عبادي، كلكم جائع إلا من أطعمته فاستطعموني أطعمكم. يا عبادي، كلكم عار إلا من كسوته فاستكسوني أكسكم. يا عبادي، إنكم تخطئون بالليل والنهار وأنا أغفر الذنوب جميعا فاستغفروني أغفر لكم. يا عبادي، إنكم لن تنفعوا ضري فتضروني ولن تبلغوا نفعي فتنفعوني. يا عبادي، لو أن أولكم وإنسكم وجن لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم كانوا على أتقى قلب رجل واحد منكم ما زاد ذلك في ملكي شيئا. يا عبادي، لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم كانوا على أفجر قلب رجل واحد منكم ما نقص ذلك من ملكي شيئا. يا عبادي، لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم قاموا على صعيد واحد فسألوني فأعطيت كل إنسان مسألته ما نقص ذلك مما عندي شيئا إلا كما ينقص المخيط إذا أدخل البحر. يا عبادي، إنما هي أعمالكم أحصيها لكم وأوفيكم إياها، فمن وجد خيرا فليحمد الله ومن وجد شرا فلا يلومن إلا نفسه. حديث صحيح رواه الإمام مسلم في صحيح رحمه الله. معاشر المؤمنين، مناسبة هذا الحديث لما نحن فيه من هذا الشهر المبارك، ألا وهو ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى في هذا الحديث القدسي أنه إنما هو الذي يطعمنا. فنحن جياع ونحن أطشاء في هذا الشهر المبارك، ولكن ربنا سبحانه وتعالى يبين لنا كمال ربوبيته سبحانه وتعالى بأنه هو الخالق الرازق المدبر، وهذا الذي يستلزم عبادته وحده لا شريك له. فهذين الأصلين عظيمان معاشر المؤمنين: الهداية والتوفيق في الدين، وقوام الحياة ورغد العيش وتأمين العيش، فعليهما يقوم عبادة الله سبحانه وتعالى ولذلك لا تعجب من قوله سبحانه وتعالى حين قال فليعبدوا رب هذا البيت، من الذي أطعمهم من جوع وآمنهم من خوف. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من أصبح منكم آمنا في سربه معافا في جسده عنده قوت يومه فكأنما حيز له الدنيا بحظافيرها. فنحن مع الأسف الشديد معاشر المؤمنين نعيش اليوم بما اصطلح عليه الناس بالحداثة، فأصبح الفردية فيها هو الأصل والقاعدة، فأصبح كل جماعة أو مجموعة وفرد يتطلع إلى نفسها دون النظر إلى غيرها وإلى الصورة الكبرى. فيجيء هذا الشهر المبارك يذكرنا بهذه الصورة الكبيرة وهذه الغاية المقصودة من خلق الإنس والجن ومن خلق الكون، ألا وهي عبادة الله سبحانه وتعالى. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا من المقبولين في هذا الشهر. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بما فيهما من الآيات والذكر الحكيم. قد قلت ما سمعتم وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه وتوبوا إليه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله على إحسانه وشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه، وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا الداعي إلى رضوانه. أما بعد، dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Abu Darda or Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu, Abu Dharr, a companion of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, narrated that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah, our Lord, said, O you my servants, indeed I have made oppression forbidden upon myself, and I've made it forbidden between you. So therefore do not oppress each other. O my slaves, my servants, all of you are misguided, except the one who I've guided. So therefore seek guidance from me and I shall guide you. O you my servants, all of you are hungry, except the ones who I have fed. So therefore seek your food and nourishment from me and I shall feed you. O you my servants, all of you are naked, except the one who I have clothed. So therefore seek your clothing from me and I shall clothe you. O my servants, indeed you sin and disobey me in the night and day, and I am the one that forgives all the sins. So therefore seek forgiveness from me and I shall forgive you. O my servants, indeed you shall never ever reach the level that you can cause me harm or bring benefit to me. O my servants, indeed if all of you, from the very first of you to the very last, and from your mankind of you and from the jinn of you, were to be united to the level that you are almost as though you are one heart of the best of you, that shall not have increased my dominion and my kingdom in any way. O my servants, if all of you, from the first of you to the very last of you, and from the mankind of you and from the jinn of you, were to be disunited, almost as though you were upon the heart of the most rebellious and sinful one of you, then indeed they shall not have detracted and reduced from my dominion anyway. O my servants, indeed, if the first of you and the last of you, and the mankind of you and the jinn of you, were all to stand up united in one ground, and all of you were to ask me a question, seeking something from me, and I gave every one of you your request, that shall not have reduced my dominion in any way, in the way that a needle when it's inserted in the ocean reduces from the water. Indeed, my servants, it is only your actions that you do, and I write them down and I collect them for you, and indeed I shall recompense you over them. So therefore, whosoever was to find good, then let them be thankful. And whosoever was to find other than that, was to find evil, then let them not blame anybody but yourself. Okay. What is the relevance? What is the connection between this hadith, this great hadith al-Qudsi, and between what we're in now, in terms of fasting, going days without food and drink, and our desires during the daytime? The connection is obvious for the one that gave some contemplation to the text. For indeed Allah said, after he made oppression haram upon himself, and therefore made justice something obligatory upon him, and therefore made it obligatory upon all of us as human beings. And then he mentioned how he guided people, and all of us would have been misguided had he not guided us. He then went on to mention food, that all of us are hungry except the one who he has fed, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is Allah clarifying to us his lordship, and this lordship entails that he's the one who created us, and therefore he's the one who sustains and nourishes us, whether it be from the heavens or from the earth, and he's the one that disposes of the affairs. So all of these things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying and justifying that he is the only one that deserves therefore to be worshipped in truth. And for this reason he created mankind and jinn. And so for that reason the hadith mentions us. And for the reason the hadith tells us to look at this bigger picture. For indeed these two elements of guidance in terms of religion and in terms of faith and in terms of guidance upon your life, and you having security in terms of food, in terms of stability, these are two very important principles upon which the whole of life becomes established and life becomes something normal. So for that reason Allah said to Quraysh, let them worship the Lord of this house. Who? The one who fed them from hunger and he made them to be in a state of peace and security and stability. And the Messenger Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whosoever was to wake up amongst you and they were to have peace and security around them, and that they had health and well-being, and then they had food which was sufficient for them in their day, then it's almost as though the whole world became their oyster. So this month came to remind us of this great blessing and this great ni'mah. Why is that? Because rather sadly we've come to live in an age of modernity, so-called. An age where individualism, where everyone and every group and perhaps even every nation is looking to itself and not looking at the bigger picture. And so for that reason you may find some certain individuals acting in certain ways which were irrational and harmful and even destructive, as we have seen in this week in some of the events which have occurred and shaken the global humanity. Why? Because everyone has become to just look about themselves and think about themselves and think about their nation, whether it be their own interests or selfish gains. But this month came to remind us of the bigger picture, and something of this hadith has a very strong connection to the very spirit of this month. Why is that? Because in this month you have the elements of unison, that we all fast together, that no matter where you are in the Muslim world, as long as the sun has begun to rise to signal the beginning of the second Fajr, you begin your fast and you wait in unison with your brothers until when the sun is going to set in sunset. So all of you, you may have seen that although the food may be placed in front of us and we are sitting there waiting for the person who is calling the prayer to pray and to call it, and not a single one of us will ever dare to stake up a date, no matter how hungry they were, or to take a sip of water until when that call has been called. That is unison. That is synchronization. That is calling all of us to have a kind of objective. But look at it also, in terms of how this month tells us to structure our lives. From before you begin the fast, you have your pre-fast meal, to after you break your fast, to when you come together, when you pray. But look at how this month, and one of its most important messages that it gives you, is not to get ahead of yourself. That you as a human being, that no matter how great you may be, no matter how many achievements you may achieve in your life, Indeed, you are just flesh and bones. That without food, you are prone to weakness. So Allah reminds you of this in this month. So therefore, he said in this hadith, the kullukum ja'i illa man at'amtu. All of you are hungry, except the one that are fed. Of course, feeding both in terms of the metaphoric meaning of feeding, in terms of spiritual food and guidance, but also the food which is hissi, the physical actual food. Where does it come from? From what the ground produces in terms of vegetation and crops and fruits, which we see as Muslims as being something that Allah has provided us from His Lordship and from His kindness to us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Islam came and the month of Ramadan came to remind you of this. So therefore, no matter how big you are, dear brother and dear sister in Islam, no matter what your status, you are only a human being. So therefore, do not get ahead of yourself. Look at the bigger picture. Because as Allah said, if all of you were to be united, and almost as though all of you had an issue to ask me and to request of me, and I gave all of you what you wanted, indeed that would not have decreased what I have in any little bit. The equivalent of what a needle that has been inserted into water reduces from the water, the huge mass of water that is in the oceans. So it teaches us to have the element of humility, to have the element of humbleness, and being submissive to our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, and giving Him what He deserves. But most importantly, as I said, since we've come to in a time and age where, as the Messenger Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam predicted, when He said, إِذَا رَأَيْتْ شُحًّا مُطَاعٌ وَهَوًّا مُتَّبَعٌ وَإِعْجَابُ كُلَّ ذِي رَأْيٍ بِرَأْيِهِ فَعَلَيْكَ بِخَوَاسِ نَفْسِكَ, that He was telling the companions, the Messenger Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, instructing them that there will come a time indeed when that you shall see people being very stingy and miserly, and people just following what they wanted and their desires. And look at this, and everybody becoming amazed by their own opinions and by their own values. So then he said, then be careful and take care of your affairs and rectify that which is between yourself and between the people that are around you. But it's not to be understood that it is a hadith that tells the Muslims to stop and the community to stop enjoining the good and forbidding the evil. For indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا عَلَيْكُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ لَا يَضُرُّكُمْ مَنْ ضَلَّ إِذَا اهْتَدَيْتُمْ. O you who believe, upon you is the responsibility over yourselves. The people who have gone astray and have been misguided shall not harm you. So there was a misunderstanding, a misconception of this great ayah. That some of the people understood from it that as long as you are righteous and that you are upon guidance, then you don't have to worry about other than you, whether they be misguided and whether they be astray. So that Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, that very noble companion of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, Ya ayyuha an-nas, innakum lataqra'una hadhihi al-ayah, walakinakum tada'unaha ala ghayri mawdi'iha. فإني سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إذا رأوا الناس المنكر فلم يغيروه أوشك الله أن يؤمهم بإقابه. He said, indeed people, you are reciting this verse, but you are putting it in other than its correct place. You are misunderstanding it and therefore implementing it wrongly. For indeed I heard the message of Allah, peace be upon him, say, indeed if a people see evil being committed plainly in front of them, and they do not rise to prevent and to prohibit this evil, then it's almost as though the entire of them are held accountable and therefore punishable in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this month came to remind us of that. So we as a Muslim community and as a global community, we have a mutual responsibility between ourselves to look out for each other and to not only see, oh, as long as I am okay and my family are okay, then you know, it doesn't matter about the other people. This against the spirit of this month. Because the spirit of this month reminds you that there are some people in this world who, unlike you, they may not have the ingredients of establishing a stable life for themselves. As in the hadith that we had mentioned. For maybe they may not be in a peace of stability and peace. Whether it be peace and stability in its physical form, of them not having wars and strife and conflict in their environments, or peace and stability in terms of their mind and their intellect. For indeed, mental health is a serious issue in our communities nowadays. And perhaps there may be somebody who may not have food that is sufficient for them, for one reason or other, whether it be due to a certain environmental phenomenon such as drought or such as famine, or whether it be poverty and homelessness. So this month came to remind you that all of you who are sitting down by that very spread of food, waiting for that moment for you to eat that food, that you are hungry. So likewise, it causes you to be in a sense of unison and to remind you of those people who are unfortunate. So therefore you start to look at the bigger picture and you start to look beyond some of these artificial boundaries of nationalism, of tribe, of race, of color, and you see that at the end of it, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, that the ghaya, the whole objective behind His creation of this entire universe and His magnificence and in His greatness is for that we worship Him alone and do not ascribe anything in worship with Him. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. As He said, indeed I have not created mankind and jinn for any other worship, for any other purpose, except that they serve me and they worship me. And this worship, as we have said time and time again, it encompasses everything that Allah loves and is pleased with, from the sayings and the actions, whether they be hidden and whether they be apparent. It goes beyond just the everyday acts of worship like praying and like fasting, to actually going out there and having a transitive benefit on people's lives and people's communities, and thereby being an active contributor to human society and to human life. This is what this month came. So all of these values, unison, synchronization, order and structure, and not getting ahead of ourselves, these are the values that this month came to cultivate in us. So therefore, what a shame therefore, that we come in to this month and we go out and we allow these values to vanish into thin air. It is not befitting for us. But rather, as some people have, people that celebrate certain festivities and certain events, they make resolutions for themselves. What is our resolution for this month? What are we going to do after this month that will make us ensure that we have bettered ourselves and that we've improved ourselves, not only in our dunya, but in our deen? Because in our religion, we do not see the separation between dunya and deen, as this very hadith mentioned, that indeed the one who was to have these elements of peace and security and guidance, and therefore food and peace and well-being, then it's almost as though the entire of the universe has been forwarded to them as their oyster, and they could do and therefore achieve whatever they wanted to. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, indeed Allah has commanded us to send prayers and salutation upon the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, when he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا فاللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وارض اللهم عن الصحابة أجمعين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعنا معهم بمنك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم آمنا في أوطاننا واصلح أئمتنا وولاة أمورنا اللهم من أرادنا وأراد الإسلام بالسوء فأشغله بنفسه وأرنا فيهم عجائب قدرتك يا قوي يا عزيز اللهم اجعل ولايتنا يا رب في من خافك واتقاك واتبع سبيل رضاك يا الله اللهم لا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار نصيرنا اللهم يا رب يا حي يا قيوم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام تقبل منا صيامنا وقيامنا واجعلنا من أتقائق من النيران يا رب اللهم اجعل لنا الفوز بالجنان يا رب العالمين اللهم كن لإخواننا المستضعفين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها اللهم أطعم جائعهم واكس آريهم يا رب عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون أقيموا الصلاة